Hello, you zombie-hating masturbators. Jim Sterling here, and this is Onichambra Z2 Chaos.
What's going on?
AKA the game that we're all ashamed of. I hate myself for enjoying it, but I do actually enjoy Onichambra. Well, this one. I expected to hate it because I played Bikini Samurai Squad, and I've seen an argument that that's better than this one, but I really did not care for Bikini Samurai Squad. I thought what that was it was just tits and blood, and that's all it wanted to be. And I expected more of the same with this, but this is tits and blood, obviously it is, but I feel like there's a lot more of a fun hack-and-slash-game to it.
It should lift once you defeat all the enemies in the area.
Anyway, they're just chatting. In fact, the game spends most of its time talking. You're concentrating on slicing all the zombies in half, and they're just nattering on and on and on, talking absolute fucking nonsense. But yeah, I've reviewed this on thejimquisition.com. This is footage I took when I first started playing it. This is from one of the earlier levels. During most of the levels, you have up to four characters, that are selectable in a level. You press the up and down the select button, the D-pad buttons, to switch between the characters on the fly. And sometimes after a gauge fills, you can unleash all of them at once and they all attack, which is pretty cool, pretty neat. Here I'm just playing with the different weapons. Every character has an A and a B weapon with their own movesets. Ton of combos. I mean, I said in the review, like, there's 33 pages on the loading screen of manual text. Like, there is a lot, really, when you get down to it. Like, chase moves, which I wasn't aware of at this point in the game, and the second
of gameplay. Pressing the triangle and circle buttons together performs a powerful move. When your ecstasy gauge is full, you can unleash an ecstasy combination. Give it a try.
Yeah, of course it's called an ecstasy combination, why wouldn't it be? But I mean, that's just one of the things you can do. Like, the amount of different things the game crams into its combat system is pretty impressive. It's pretty damn impressive. With charge attacks, combo moves, ecstasy moves, transformation moves, like, it's... there's a ton, and I was quite impressed with that. I found Bikini Samurai Squad to be just... I don't know, just this lengthy, grueling, boring slog. Whereas this just feels faster and more... still an absolute fucking mess of a game. I mean, look at it. But it's a fun mess. It's a mess I can enjoy. And there we are. There's a big old crotch shot for you. Because. I mean, there that's really all the justification the game ever has for itself. Because. There's no justifying any of it. But again, as I noted in my write-up of it, it was Randy Pitchford who tried to defend Duke Nukem Forever by comparing it to a big greasy hamburger. He was trying to say, you know, some people like junk food games and that's what Duke Nukem Forever is. But, I mean, Duke Nukem Forever's big greasy hamburger was basically all of the grease soaked into a moldy wheat bun. The burger had been taken out and thrown away. And then that had just been left to kind of congeal for 13 years and thrown on a plate, not even a high quality plate, like a rubbish plate, like a plastic one, no, a paper one, paper plate. Whereas this, I feel, is much closer to the actual hamburger analogy, because it's pure fucking junk. It's trash, but it's enjoyable trash, you know. You'll feel ill after enjoying it. You'll hate yourself when you're done. But you won't deny that you enjoyed it while you did, and you'll go back to it like a greasy little burger bastard. Greasy burger pig. That's what you are. You fucking disgusting burger pig. Yeah, again, this is a very early level, so I'm just trying to think this. Yeah, this is actually like the first real level. And I'm just testing shit out. All the different stuff I can do. All the yellow orbs you pick up, you know, they go towards unlocking. You can upgrade your weapons and your sub-weapons. You can get more combo moves. That's still cool. I still like that gimmick of the flicking the weapon to get the blood off it. Me just taking the opportunity to heal a bit. And yeah, just the way the camera zooms in and that very minor slowdown. Like, some games do the whole slowdown when you kill certain things and it can be quite obtrusive, but this is just, it's a very quick zoom in and zoom out. And I find that pretty neat. Just like that, just zoom in, zoom out, just to give you a good view of all the blood. And the ass shots that they will claim later is just purely coincidental and it's not their fault the camera did that. I know after my review someone said, oh, well, I guess we'll let them talk. Check out how big it is.
Big enough that you could keep any pet you wanted down here.
I think this might be a little much for your average pet. The size of animal it calls for probably doesn't...
None of the dialogue matters. None of what they say matters. The story doesn't matter. It's all nonsense. And that's part of the enjoyment factor. So if I'd have known about the chase thing at this point, this fight would have been easier. This didn't go well for me. Moles are annoying. I hate enemies that burrow in the ground in games. Fucking freaks. I really did need to heal up at this point and somehow neglected doing so. Should have hit the touchpad as well to have brought in the secondary characters so they both could have attacked at once, but I didn't do that. I didn't do that either. I was just been trying out the targeting system just to try and keep a bead on these fuckers. Now if you hold down the X button, which I learned in the next level, if you hold down the X button, you do what's called the chase move, where you basically just do a homing lunge at the nearest enemy, which is much better for closing distances and finding enemies to begin with. It's kind of like Sonic the Hedgehog, like modern Sonic the Hedgehog games and his homing attack that he does.
Oh, you ain't half bad. But now it's my turn.
Hey, no shoving!
Then stay out of my way.
I like to imagine this game had 20 writers.
Kagura! Damn it. This is what happens when you try to show off like that.
All the time for a lecture.
You know I have no obligation to save you, right? Screw it.
Nobody has that much blood in it. Most of it went everywhere else, not in her gob.
What? What's going on? That should have healed you.
Yeah, you shouldn't be talking right now. You've lost all of your blood.
My body is tearing apart! Kagura!
You're sure as hell ain't gonna die in a place like...
So that happened.
Is this your true form?
Yeah.
Okay, I see where this is going. This blood mixing with my own.
Whoa, this is fucking sweet! Oi! Mogra!
Gotta give credit to the voice acting. It is fucking ludicrous. just me reading there. And so this is pre-recorded. I'm speaking after the fact to you right now with my voice. Wasn't quite as vigilant as I should have been about flipping the blood off the weapons either. Kind of took me a bit more playing into the game to remember to do that more often. Obviously, that was a big gimmick of the other Onochamaru game stuff. And it's still, there's still just something cool about it. Like it really doesn't do anything to add to the game, but it's just a nice touch. Just that flicking of the blood to refresh your weapon. They call it the refresh, and then you do more damage with the weapon. Basically decreases in damage output the more blood's on it. So anyway, we're almost done with this part of it, and then we've got another level with the other two characters. I really wish I'd have known about the homing thing at this point. But I didn't! Cut that right in half. Suppose I'll take the opportunity, since we're having a nice casual video, to... well, that wasn't very good, was it? Rank C, rubbish. Rank C for crap. Bun. Doggo. I have no idea what's going on.
Bring the ceiling down. That's the idea. If there ain't no exit, then we make one.
Fair point, innit? Dune. Gara Gara. Bun. Why? Why Bun? Why Bun? Sask. Silver. Not very good. Oh well. Oh well. Anyway, other characters. Church.
Why something like this here?
Come, Jim, press X, you prick.
Who cares? Anywhere's better than where we just were. Besides, Aya could be around here too. So stop dragging your tits and let's keep moving.
Dragging your tits.
Stop dragging my... Excuse me? Okay.
Sometimes I have to struggle to come up with a subtitle for the videos, but stop dragging your tits. I mean, it's already pre-written for me, isn't it? But anyway, as I was saying, this is a nice laid-back video, and there's not exactly much variety in the action on screen to really commentate on. Might as well talk to you about how many old role-playing RPG games are going. We're on back on the D&D again, 5th edition. We're currently still doing our Eberron campaign. Chasing some sort of what we think is a vampire, basically throughout half the world. He's got an artifact from our city of Greyghast, and we're trying to get it back. And we were on an airship, and I was thrown off the airship. I was executed for murder because I found one of our enemies in one of the compartments on the airship and killed her. Because my character is a bit hot-headed like that, and they put me on trial, the trial of Cozard Crane. And they found me guilty. I mean, I was found not guilty on 3 of the charges, but the 4th count of murder most foul, they didn't go for it, for my explanation. But that's besides the point, I was thrown off. Luckily, we've got a warlock who's got a familiar, and the familiar was invisible and was clinging on to me as I was kicked off. And he had a fly potion on him, so I had that. Got glug, glug, glug. Flew my way back up to the airship. Unfortunately, another battle went on up there. another airship crashed into ours and like piratey things got off. And one of our other party members got tossed off the airship. And I failed the dex check by one. It was a DC of 15. And I needed a DC of 15. No, I already said that. It was a DC of 15 and I rolled fucking 14. Missed him by a hair's breadth. And he fell right down past me. So I tried to fly back down after him because in my character's backstory, this dude saved my life. He got me out of Thrain after an assassination attempt. So I'm like, well, I'm not going to let him die. So I dove down after him. There was no way I was going to get there.
Be careful.
And then our warlock friend Familia offered me a deal.
Ecstasy combinations to defeat.
He was like, you know, if you do a little thing for me, we can rescue that dude. And I won't say exactly what the deal was yet because I know some of the game guys watch these videos and they are not yet to know, but it is going to change my character big time and it's going to be fun. Will involve a little bit of multi-classing, which wasn't my original plan. My original plan was to go straight champion fighter up to level 20, but fuck it, life's too short, so I took the idea that was more story interesting. Interesting story-wise. And it facilitates a change of character. Not alignment, because we decided to just not bother with alignments because there's too many arguments over what is and what isn't lawful evil. As is my want to try and get away with being lawful evil. And then that DM doesn't like it too much. So we just said, fuck it, sod alignment, just play your character however they would be played. Which, you know, is fairly freeing. But anyway, that'll be fun. I'm most excited about getting back to the Aberrant game, if I'm honest. I love Aberrant. I like White Wolf games. There's actually a couple of folks as I know, Brian and Beth, they are running a playing a vampire game. They're in Arizona, doing a vampire game. I love Vampire the Masquerade. Never done the other one, but I do like the Masquerade. And obviously, you know, they're not in the same area as me, so I can't play it with them. But one of their characters apparently has a like one of the character features. I guess it's a merit of supernatural spouse or something. So they're like, do you want to pretend to be a mage and call this other player up as their estranged lover? So I'm coming up with ideas for a mage character that would be involved in it somehow. Just so I can vicariously live through others as they play vampire. Because our vampire game has just been abandoned because it became quite apparent that someone was going to kill someone. And when someone, I mean everyone was probably going to kill, except for me. I was the least trusted character and probably the most loyal. I wasn't planning to kill anybody, but they all thought I was planning to kill them. Just because my character was a Malkavian who wears a mask all the time and is really sinister sounding and suspicious sounding. Oh, that was me fucking that up because I didn't realise that the QTEs were touchpad swipes. Got it that time though. But yeah, I don't know why more games with QTEs haven't gone that route. It actually feels quite nice to just swipe as a QTE on that touchpad. I like it. But anyway. But yeah, hoping to get back to the Aberrant game at some point because I really like my character. I basically made Mysterio. I mean, he didn't start that way. He's kind of this corporate espionage kind of dude. He started off with Disorient and Disrupt so he can cancel other Nova powers and make people dizzy and sick. And then I got Hollow. I didn't know Hollow was a thing until it was pointed out to me. I'm like, Hollow? So that means I can have Mysterio powers, right? And so obviously I bought the shit out of that. And then now I'm gonna get density control so that my character can be incorporeal, which would be nice because I keep getting shot to death because I'm one of those guys who I never got the timing on that fucking shit. But it'd be nice to be incorporeal because I'm unlike other people who play Aberrant, sort of the typical player, I didn't bother with any of the any of the stamina upgrades or super strength or anything like that. I basically just am a bloke who can do all the sort of mindy things, you know, you can mess with characters, but, you know, what can you do? Anyway, that's the chase in action, just zooming about. It's really fun. That's an unfortunate shot. I like Aberrant though. I get so many ideas for it because there's so much versatility in that system. Just all the different powers, and not just all the different powers, but the way you can implement them if you've got the imagination for it. Like my main use of Hollow, like the hologram power, is to hollow my own face. Because my character's got like Cypher 5 and doesn't like to be found. At this point, I got lost like an idiot and just wandered around, not realizing the door was right there. But I found it now. There we go. I think this is my favourite character to play as. I like the chainsaw, it's got a real weighty sense to it. I like her punches as well. I didn't really fuck around with their sub-weapons too much. Well, there we go. I love that, like the way it just... There's this almost resistance as the chainsaw goes through characters, and it just gives it this sense that you're chewing through them, which I like. Maybe I'm more awesome. But that wraps it up. That's my gameplay video of that. VVV, thank you very much. Platinum, son. Because I'm Jim fucking Sterling, son. And that's how it's done. See you later. Bye.